So after finishing the discussion with reference to the proprietorship concern, its features, its merits, its limitations, we had started talking about the concept of partnership, when we understood that what are the different terms which are important with reference to partnership, like what is a partner, what is a firm, what is an agreement of partnership. These all things is what we had talked about. Now let's talk about the features of partnership firm. हम लोग पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म पे प्रोप्राइटरशिप से क्यों गए थे, क्योंकि वी वांटेड टू हैव द एडिशनल रिसोर्सेस, वी वांटेड टू हैव समवन हु कैन शेयर आवर रिस्क, वी वांट टू कैरी आउट द एक्टिविटीज विद द बेटर मैनेजमेंट, एंड फॉर दैट पर्पस देयर आर सर्टेन स्पेसिफिक फीचर्स गिवन विद रेफरेंस टू पार्टनरशिप. The very first in that is what? That there has to be an agreement between the partners. Because when two different parties are coming together, when two different persons are coming together, they are carrying out their activities at their individual levels. Those two parties, when they come together, they should have a common agenda. They should have a common thought process. And for that purpose, it is said that there has to be an agreement between the partners. Because if such agreement is not there, then it may lead to certain confusions at a later point in time. Like that confusion can be for certain share of profits, that confusion can be for the kind of share of losses, the management, anything. So to avoid such confusions, to avoid such difficulties, to avoid such practical situations at a later date, it's always better to have a separate agreement in which there will be the specific terms and conditions written between the partners, which are agreed between the partners. Of course, if there is no agreement as such, if there is no agreement written, then does not mean that the partnership cannot take place. Even if a written agreement is not there, the partnership business can still work. In such situation, for those organizations where there is no partnership agreement, or when the partnership deed is silent about certain things, in that case, in such situation, instead of having the partnership agreement, they follow the Partnership Act. In the kind of disputes, in the kind of problems, the provisions of the Partnership Act will be followed in that case when there is no agreement, that is, there is an oral partnership. Oral partnership can also happen, but it's always advisable, it's always suggestible that whenever a partnership is formed, it should have a separate partnership deed, because it brings a better authenticity to the organization. Partnership is an outcome of an agreement between two or more persons who are conducting the partnership business for earning the profit. So important terms in that is, in these are what? Agreement for earning, conducting partnership for earning profit. All right. The agreement between the partners may be oral or written. This agreement can be oral or written. When it is written agreement, in that case, the provisions, the clauses, the information, the terms and conditions as per the partnership deed or partnership agreement will be picked up in the situation of dispute. But if there is an oral partnership, in such case, the provisions of Indian Partnership Act are followed. It is always advisable to have a written agreement between all partners. Why written agreement? Because it clearly covers majority of the disputes or problems at a later date. All right. Then whatever is the firm's property is the property of all partners. That is why it is said that, yeah, of course, partnership agreement gives you the better clarity about the terms and condition. And that's why the written agreement has to be there. Yeah. So I was on to the point that whatever are the properties of the firm, in those properties of the firm, all the partners have the joint ownership. Means what? If the firm is having certain building in the name of firm, if the firm is having certain furniture, certain goods, these all things are having the joint ownership of all the partners. If at all, due to any situation, the partnership firm gets dissolved, that is closed. In such case, these assets after paying off the outside liabilities, bahar walon ko pay karne ke baad, matlab, if there is any dues from the government, if there is any dues to the creditors, these all things, after paying all these things, whatever assets remain, for that the situation is very simple. That is, kaddu katega to sab mein batega. So whatever are the remaining assets, those remaining assets will be utilized to pay off all the liabilities, all the partners in their appropriate share. Because all the partners have the joint ownership. Now, joint ownership does not mean equal ownership. Joint ownership can be unequal ownership also. Like one of the partner is having 30% share, another partner is having 40% share, there is another partner who is having 15% share, another partner is there who is having 15% share. That can happen. But they all will have the right in the property of the firm. Sanskruti, what you are mentioning, that oral agreement is a risky element. Of course, that's why it is always advisable that you should go for the written partnership deed. Still, people have the belief, people have the confidence, and therefore they don't draw the partnership, or there can be a short duration partnerships also. In such case, we follow the provisions of Indian Partnership Act. So law is there. Law is there to cover up where the situations come, wherever the disputes come. In that case, the law is also available or not. And therefore, even the oral partnership is allowed. हाँ, अगर उसके लिए कोई और law ही नहीं होता, तो हमें दिक्कत आ सकती थी. That's why it is permitted. The firm is jointly owned by the partners. The partners have to use the partnership property only for business purpose and not for personal use. That is typically what happens. And actual disputes यहीं से start होते हैं. कि वो पार्टनरशिप के कोई एम्प्लॉयज है उनको वो पर्सनल काम बोलते रहता है, वो पार्टनरशिप का कोई प्रॉपर्टी है वो पर्सनल यूज में यूज करता है, और वहां से वो डिस्प्यूट स्टार्ट होते हैं. दैट्स व्हाट इज सेड दैट यू आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू यूटिलाइज द फर्म्स प्रॉपर्टी फॉर द फर्म्स पर्पस ओनली. जॉइंट मैनेजमेंट, इसी के लिए तो हम पार्टनरशिप करने जा रहे थे कि आई शुड हैव द एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन इन the decision making of the firm, the management of the firm. Every partner has the right to take active participation in the management of the business. However, one or more partners may agree to manage business on behalf of other partners in the firm. Now, this is also possible. If all the other partners agree to it, in such case, the control of the firm may be given to one of the partner who will carry out all the activities, all the business related to the partnership firm. this is possible. But however, we have to take care of it, that if you are giving that control to someone, then whether that person is having the eligibility, experience, knowledge, skill set for that or not. So that's why it is said that otherwise, all the partners will have the active participation, but the partners may agree upon that, that we should give the right of controlling, managing to a single person. The partnerships cannot take place for the illegal activities. That means, agar aapko legal partnership karni hai, to uske liye aapke paas lawful business hona chahiye. Aap logon ki supari lene ke liye partnership karenge, wo illegally aap kar sakte hain. Wo aapki oral partnership ho sakti hai. जैसे कोई भाई वन मेक्स द पार्टनरशिप विद भाई टू फॉर कवरिंग द मल्टीपल एरियाज, वो जनरली होता नहीं है, बट स्टिल दैट कैन हैपन, बट दैट्स एन ओरल पार्टनरशिप. उसके लिए उन्होंने पार्टनरशिप डीड बनाया, वो साइन कराया, यू कैन नॉट डू दैट. एवरी पार्टनरशिप फर्म मस्ट अंडरटेक ओनली लॉफुल बिजनेस. The partnership should not engage in the business which is forbidden by the law of land. Forbidden by law of land, which means that which is not allowed to be conducted as per the legal terms of the given place where you are entering into that partnership deed. The partnership cannot be formed to carry out any unlawful business, like partnership formed to smuggle the goods. वो अगर आपने पिक्चर देखी होगी बदमाश कंपनी, दैट बदमाश कंपनी वाज एन इलीगल एक्टिविटी. दे वर ट्राइंग टू फूल द पीपल ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट अथॉरिटीज. दैट काइंड ऑफ पार्टनरशिप इज नॉट अलाउड टू बी डन. सेल ऑफ इलीगल आर्म्स और टेकिंग सुपारीज ऑफ द पीपल. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज टेकिंग सुपारीज ऑफ द पीपल. नॉट द टेकिंग सुपारी फॉर डांसिंग, बट टेकिंग सुपारी फॉर. Forbidden is not allowed. Something which is disallowed as per the rules of the place where you are taking the activity, that is where you are doing the activity, is called as forbidden by the law of land. Write down that term. Forbidden means not allowed. Forbidden means not allowed. Law of land means, I hope you are writing. आजकल कोई वीडियो ऑन ही नहीं करता है तो मुझे समझ नहीं आता है. एक आध दो लोग वीडियो ऑन करते हैं और बाकी सारे बंद करके बैठे रहते हैं. Law of land means the different rules and laws, the different rules and laws, of course not the in-laws, applicable at, applicable at the place where the partnership is done. Applicable at the place where the partnership is done. That is what we call as the law of land. All right. Now, even in this case, that is in the case of partnership also, there is an unlimited liability. What do I mean by unlimited liability? That I've already explained to you. That all the assets of the firm will first be utilized for the purpose of paying the firm's liabilities. Now, after that also, if there is the liability remaining, such liability will be paid from the personal assets of the partners. Now, here there is one important term mentioned. That is, partner's liability is unlimited, joint, and several. Understand this concept very carefully now. What is this unlimited, joint, and several? Now, let's say there is this partnership. All right. In which partners are Mr. Amir, Mr. Gareeb, and Mr. Bhikari. And their firm name is Ajab and Company. All right. Now, Ajab and Company having the partners as Amir, Gareeb, and Bhikari. All right. In tino mein bahut achhi chal rahi thi. ये लोग रोज दर दर भटक भटक के भीख मांग रहे थे. भिखारी भीख मांगता था, वो गरीब को देखता था, वो गरीब को कुछ देता था, और फिर गरीब से छीन के अमीर और अमीर हो रहा था. दैट वॉज द काइंड ऑफ पार्टनरशिप दैट दे हैड. नाउ एट अ लेटर डेट व्हाट हैपेंड, दे गॉट इनटू अ सिचुएशन वेयर भिखारी गॉट फ्रस्ट्रेटेड. यार सारी मेहनत मैं कर रहा हूं, पैसा तुम लेके जा रहे हो, मेरे पास कुछ बचता ही नहीं है. तो भिखारी वेंट इनटू द डिस्प्यूट. भिखारी सेड नथिंग डूइंग, आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद यू. आमिर सेड इफ भिखारी इज नॉट कंटिन्यूइंग इवन आई डोंट वांट टू कंटिन्यू. दे फाइनली डिसाइडेड दैट वी विल डिसॉल्व दिस फॉर्म, वी विल क्लोज दिस पर्टिकुलर फॉर्म. नाउ when they decided that they will close this particular firm, of course all the liabilities of the firm will be paid to the creditors or not. Jitne bhi aapke creditors hain un sabko aapko paisa wapas dena padega. You cannot keep that money ki bhar do jholi mein. You cannot have that kind of situation. So for that purpose what they did, ye jo ship thi sabse pehle ship ka khatma hua. Amir, Gareeb and Bhikari got this ship sold first. Are sab ek saath ja rahe hain. Amir, Gareeb aur Bhikari ke paas se sabse pehle ye ship chali gayi. All right. ये शिप बेच के जो पैसा आया उससे उन्होंने उनकी पहले लाइबिलिटीज पे की. पर इसके बाद भी दे रियलाइज दैट स्टिल देयर इज एन अमाउंट ऑफ 5 लाख पेएबल. लाइबिलिटीज ऑफ फर्म आफ्टर पेइंग फ्रॉम firm's assets. Firm की assets खत्म हो गई. अब हुआ यूं कि वो creditors तो अभी भी आ रहे. अब अमीर गरीब भिखारी वो creditors को ऐसा नहीं बोल सकते हैं कि वो जो firm's की asset थी वो खत्म हो गई, अब तुमको पैसा नहीं मिलेगा, money इल्ल. They cannot say something like that. Why? Because when the partnership is formed, in that case, the third party deals with the firm, assuming that partners are responsible for everything. It's not the firm, but the partner, because firm did not have a separate legal status at all. So that liability now becomes that of Amir, Gareeb and Bhikari jointly. राइट आप भिखारी अपने घर से 50,000 रुपये लेके आया, कहता है ये मेरी मैक्सिमम असेट्स अवेलेबल है, इसके बियॉन्ड मेरे पास कुछ नहीं है. सो एंड आफ्टर दैट ही बिकम्स इंसॉल्वेंट. अब हुआ क्या कि भिखारी के असेट्स में से 50,000 रुपये पे हो गया, करेक्ट और नॉट? लॉजिकली देखा जाए तो इफ सपोज देयर पार्टनरशिप वॉज दैट दे वेर हैविंग द शेयर्स इन द रेशियो ऑफ देयर पार्टनरशिप वॉज इन द रेशियो ऑफ 3:1:1, मतलब क्या कि जो भी पार्टनरशिप के असेट्स मिलेंगे, प्रॉफिट मिलेगा, उसको ये लोग 5 हिस्सों में बांटेंगे. उन 5 हिस्सों में से 3 हिस्से जाएंगे अमीर को, एक हिस्सा गरीब को, एक हिस्सा भिखारी को, करेक्ट? दिस वॉज द एक्सपेक्टेशन. बट अब क्या हो रहा है, भिखारी ने लॉजिकली उसके हिस्से के हिसाब से 1,00,000 रुपए देना चाहिए था, 5 लाख में से 1/5 उसने 1,00,000 रुपए देना चाहिए था या नहीं? पर भिखारी के पास जो असेट्स बची हैं उसमें से तो सिर्फ 50,000 रुपये निकला. नाउ दैट डज नॉट मीन अमीर एंड गरीब सेइंग टू द क्रेडिटर्स कि वो भिखारी का 1,00,000 का शेयर था, उसमें से उसने 50,000 दिया, बाकी 50,000 भूल जाओ. इट इज द सेवरल लाइबिलिटी ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर पार्टनर ऑल्सो. सो इट्स नॉट ओनली द जॉइंट लाइबिलिटी, बट दीज पार्टनर हैव द इंडिविजुअल लाइबिलिटीज एज वेल. सेवरल मीन्स इंडिविजुअल. तो ये 50,000 देने के बाद अब ये जो 4.5 लाख रुपए बचे हैं, इन 4.5 लाख की लाइबिलिटी रही अमीर गरीब पर. And they both will be required to give that in the share of 3:1. अब मान लो गरीब के पास सिर्फ, अब 3:1 के हिसाब से इन दोनों ने मिला के अब गरीब के शेयर में से 1,12,500 देने चाहिए उसने, पर गरीब के पास भी सपोज सिर्फ 60,000 रुपए बचे हैं, तो द रिमेनिंग अमाउंट विल बी पेड बाय आमिर. और उसके बाद आमिर भी बोलता नहीं मेरे पास भी 2.5 लाख ही बचे हैं, बाकी नहीं है. Then in that case, it will be the loss of the creditors. Did you understand this? So first will be the liability of all of them jointly, together. They will be required to pay, they will be required to pay the liabilities out of their assets. But if their individual assets are also insufficient, then it is the loss of the creditors. Got it? 100% insolvent ke case mein wahi hoga, that they do not have the asset at all. That can also be the situation. Correct or not? Huh. So this is the concept of joint and several responsibility. Sanskriti, we don't call that as bad debts. We call that as deficiency. Because we are the people who have taken the liability. अगर हमारे assets होते और उसमें से पैसे नहीं आ पा रहे हैं, then in that case it is called as bad debts. So when receivables become irrecoverable, it is called as bad debts. But when payables are not, you are not able to make the payment towards the payables, that is called as deficiency. Write down. When receivables become irrecoverable, those are called as bad debts, and no one likes the bad debts, you know. सर कहां आप हमें 11th स्टैंडर्ड में ऐसे छेड़ रहे हो, हम बेचारे छोटे छोटे बच्चे, हमारे सामने आप डेट्स के बारे में बात करोगे जिसमें आपने हमको आज तक क्लास पे भी नहीं बुलाया है, हम डेट पे जाए किसके साथ? Isn't it? सर ऐसे तो बहुत डेट हो गई हमारी, 10th तक के तो हमने मतलब लाइन लगाई थी. Isn't it?
नहीं सर, अभी भी जाते हैं, मौके निकाल निकाल के घर वालों को झूठ बोल बोल के निकल जाते हैं। नहीं अब तक? माय गुडनेस, कितने इनोसेंट बच्चे हो ना आप, गुड बॉयज गुड गर्ल्स। गुनेन बोलता है मैं नहीं, मैं नहीं, प्लीज डोंट कैटेगराइज मी इनटू दिस। I am having lot of dates, जो मैं रोज सुबह उठते से ही दूध के साथ खाता हूं, बोलता है। वो होते हैं ना खजूर डेट्स, यू नो, तुमको क्या लगा था? वही ना, दुबई नहीं, अमान, अमान डेट्स आर वेरी गुड। चलो जाने दो सर। आपने अचानक ऐसे कोई तो स्टेटमेंट बनाते हो, उसमें हमारे सारे जज्बात, सारा वक्त बदल जाता है। हम सोच कुछ रहे होते हैं, आप बोल कुछ देते हो, बाद में फिर हमारी सोच बदल देते हो। क्यों ऐसे करते हो सर? हम लोग कितने खुश हो गए थे कि आज कुछ तो हमारे दिल की बात हो रही थी, कहीं तो मास्टर हमारे दिल की बात समझ रहा है। घर में हम घर वालों को समझा समझा के परेशान हो गए, कुछ समझने की कोशिश ही नहीं कर रहे हैं। हम घर वालों को बोलते हैं मैं जाके सब्जी लेके आता हूं, उस बहाने किसी को मिलाऊंगा, तो घर वाले बोलते नहीं बार कोरोना है, और खुद जा जा के घूम के आते हैं। पर ठीक है, आ जाएंगे आ जाएंगे, अभी बस वैक्सीन आ ही रहा है नो? वो क्या डील फिक्स नहीं हो रहा है ना? वो डील फिक्स होएगा तो वैक्सीन आएगा ना। गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट एबल टू फिक्स द डील विद द कंपनीज। गवर्नमेंट मीन्स जिन जो भी अथॉरिटीज हैं, वो अपना अपना शेयर फिक्स कर रही हैं, किसको कितना मिलेगा। वैक्सीन नहीं, वैक्सीन से बड़ी चीज होती है नो, विटामिन एम। उसके बाद तय होगा कि किसको कौन से टाइप के वैक्सीन मिलेंगे। आर्या, ये न्यू टाइप का कोरोना सिर्फ हवा है, ये मैं सीरियसली कहता हूं तुम लोगों को। अभी ये क्रिसमस हॉलीडेज में लोग सतर्क हो जाने चाहिए, इसलिए इन्होंने ये न्यू टाइप का कोरोना लेके आ गए कि अगले 15 दिन तक के लोग बहुत ज्यादा भीड़ ना करें, इसलिए ये सब गड़बड़ कर रहे हैं। यू जस्ट गो एंड चेक आउट, मैं तुमको 110% बोलता हूँ, 15 दिन बाद वापस सारा कुछ रिलैक्स हो जाएगा। नहीं, वो न्यू टाइप का कोरोना भी सब रुक गया। नो, पेशेंट्स आर देयर सतेज, पेशेंट्स आर देयर। I fear from that situation. But the point, yes, Ishan, that's an absolute correct point, that fear is the key factor in democracy. You create the fear and you win that particular game. So I agree that there is this corona effect, but the point is what they people, especially in Britain, UK, US, Europe, wherever you go, there these people have the lesser immunity. That's their basic problem. Hamare saath advantage kya ho raha hai? I'm not saying that we should, because of that, we should just go out. Hamare saath advantage ye hai ki comparatively hamare paas immunity bahut achhi hai. Ye log khana frozen khate hai, 15-15 din ka rakha hua khana khate hai. And there are so many factors in that. And therefore it is said, that they are having more risk as compared to what we have. Otherwise, US mein aaj sabse achhi medical facilities, US, Italy kind of places, sabse achhi medical facilities. Aur US mein 4-4 lakh case ek din mein nikalte hain. Aur hamare yahan 130 crore ka population aur ab jaake hum log 1 crore paar kiye hain. Yes, of course, we are having more young generation. That is also making the positive effect, because that young generation is more immune. So these kind of factors are there. Well, any which ways, vaccine aayega, hamare yahan sara kuch relax ho jayega. Hum log jo April wala batch announce kiye hai na, 1st April se 12th standard ka batch, that is going to start from 1st April. So don't you worry. And
probably this is my gut feeling, 90% of chances are that we'll be meeting in person. In fact, I'm making the timetable based on that only, that we are going to have that session in person only. And we'll have fun in that. But anyways, let's come back. So liability, when we talk about,
स्क्रीन चला गया. नहीं समृद्धि, वी डू नॉट हैव द क्रिसमस हॉलीडे. क्रिसमस हॉलीडे करेगी क्या? महाराष्ट्र में वैसे भी तो कर्फ्यू लगा हुआ है, नाइट कर्फ्यू. वैसे भी घर पे बैठना है तेरे को. कब है क्रिसमस? है कब? फ्राइडे को है ना? हाँ ठीक है, देखेंगे. हाँ हम सिर्फ वो दो ही लेक्चर रखेंगे उस दिन बस, ओसीएम के, एंड बाकी सारे लेक्चर नॉर्मल होंगे. सो नो हॉलीडे, नो हॉलीडे. वो सिलेबस आगे बढ़ते रहना चाहिए, दैट्स नेसेसरी. वैसे भी घर बैठे हो, तुमको कुछ करना है नहीं, और कोई काम है नहीं तुम्हारे पास, क्या करोगे छुट्टियां लेके? घर पे बैठ के ऐसे बूबू करोगे, पागल. वेल तो बाहर जा रहे हो, तुमको तुम तो लेक्चर कहीं से भी बैठ के अटेंड कर सकते हो. मैं कहीं पे भी जाके लेक्चर ले सकता हूं, तुम कहीं पे भी बैठ के लेक्चर अटेंड नहीं कर सकते. हद हो गई यार ये तो, मतलब सीरियसली. ओके, the liability of each partner is unlimited, joint and several. I've already tried to explain that. We'll just read the text on that now. The unlimited liability arises when the assets of the firm are not sufficient to pay off the claims of the creditors. The private properties of partners are attached to satisfy such claims. Attached means what? Those will be utilized for the purpose of paying the firm's liabilities. The joint liability indicates that each and every partner is jointly liable with other partners for the debt of the firm, whether incurred by himself or by other partners. That doesn't make any difference. Agar wo firm ki liability hai, to uske liye responsibility sare partners ki hogi. Aisa nahi ki ye maine is wale agreement mein main nahi tha, ये वाले ट्रांजैक्शन में मैं नहीं था, तो ये वाला लायबिलिटी मैं पे नहीं करेगा. ऐसा नहीं चलेगा. कद्दू कटेगा तो सब में बटेगा. सेवरल लायबिलिटी मींस दैट ईच एंड एवरी पार्टनर इज इंडिविजुअली एंड सेपरेटली लायबल फॉर द डेट्स ऑफ द फर्म, वेदर इनकर्ड बाय हिमसेल्फ और अदर पार्टनर्स. व्हाई? बिकॉज इफ वन ऑफ द पार्टनर इज नॉट एबल टू पे ऑफ द फर्म्स लायबिलिटीज पर्सनली, then another partner who is having sufficient assets will, his liabilities will, his assets will be used for paying the liabilities. All right, then maximum number of partners, aap anginat partners nahi rakh sakte ho. There is a maximum limit being put, but understand my dear friends, this limit of partners is not put by the Partnership Act. This limit of partners is put by the Companies Act. क्योंकि कॉर्पोरेट स्ट्रक्चर में जाने के लिए आप एक नंबर के बियॉन्ड जा सकते हो. अगर आप नॉन कॉर्पोरेट स्ट्रक्चर में हो तो यू कैन हैव मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ पार्टनर्स विच आर प्री स्पेसिफाइड इन द कंपनीज एक्ट. करंटली परमिटेड आर 50, विच कैन बी एक्सटेंडेड अप टू 200 बाय द कंपनीज एक्ट. करंटली इट इज 50 ओनली मैक्सिमम नंबर. ऑलराइट, Vedant is asking, sir, if one of the partner dies, in that case, his hair color will become black, my dear friend. He dies, na? Well, in that case, also, his successors will be responsible for paying the firm's liabilities. उसके सक्सेसर को, मतलब लीगल हेयर्स को, उसके चिल्ड्रन को जो भी असेट्स मिली है, फ्रॉम दैट दे विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू पे ऑफ द फर्म्स लाइबिलिटीज. Why there are so many shareholders? Because it's a company. Company does not have the restriction. All right. Next is principal agent relationship. ये हमने पहले भी discuss किया था. Principal agent relationship means what? That partners will have one working for all working for one. हाँ, संस्कृति ने अपने बारे में पूछ लिया. Sir, if there is a minor partner, then what? माइनॉर, बराबर है ना? माइन इज मैगी, माइन इज नॉट नॉर. वो होता है नॉर सूपी नूडल्स. हाँ, आई लाइक मैगी. एनीवेज, चलो ठीक है, जाने दो, वापस आए थे. सर आप ना सुबह सुबह अब थोड़ा ज्यादा हो रहा है. माइनॉर इफ देर इज अ पार्टनर, understand and remember this forever. As per the Indian Contract Act, a person who has not yet attained the age of 18 years is considered as a minor. A minor is not allowed to enter into any agreement. इसीलिए आप लोग ने ऑब्जर्व किया रहेगा, आप जब कॉलेज में एडमिशन लेते हो तो वहां आपको पेरेंट्स का सिग्नेचर देना पड़ता है, बिकॉज यू आर नॉट अलाउड टू एंटर इनटू द एग्रीमेंट. आप बैंक में अकाउंट ओपन करते हो तो वहां पे आपको गार्जियन का सिग्नेचर लेना पड़ता है, बिकॉज यू कैन नॉट डू इट योरसेल्फ, बिकॉज यू आर अ माइनर एज पर द इंडियन पार्टनरशिप इंडियन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्ट. The same rule applies even in the case of partnership. However, partnership allows the minor to be a partner, but only for benefits. So, partner can enter into a partnership for profits only. If there is any loss or liability, that will not be payable by the partner being a minor individually. Is it point right? That will not be the responsibility of that minor partner in that case. That will be the responsibility only of the major partners. If one, see, when there is a death of a partner, that's a different thing. Because in case of a death of a partner, the firm provides the partner who is deceased, his children, his legal heirs have got the property. That property will be utilized for the purpose of paying the firm's liability, because at that time he was not the partner. He got those assets in succession. So those can be utilized. But when I am a partner as such, being a minor, then my assets won't be utilized for paying the liabilities. क्योंकि जब भी पार्टनर एग्रीमेंट कर रहे थे उस समय पे मेरा एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन अलाउड ही नहीं था. अल्टीमेटली इट वॉज द एग्रीमेंट बिटवीन द मेजर पार्टनर्स एंड द आउटसाइडर्स. राइट, कैन वी डू जॉब और स्टार्ट बिजनेस आफ्टर 14? यू कैन डू जॉब बट नॉट द बिजनेस. बिजनेस आपको without, because you will not be allowed to open the account, you won't be having the shop act license, for everything you need to be a major. So, tab tak aapko aapke guardian ke saath nahi karna padega, but you can do the job, there is no problem. The job that does not involve the heavy physical work can be done after the age of 14. The job that allows the physical work, that can be carried out after the age of 16. This is as per the labor laws. If there are more partners, then will there be more profit? Arya, it all depends on their management capacity. It all depends on how they carry out the activities. More partners, more profit can also be the situation. More partners, more confusion can also be the situation. And that's why when the number of partners are higher, they assign a managing partner, and that managing partner carries out all the activities in that situation. So they make the division between ownership and management in such situation. Well, I'll stop by here itself. We'll continue with the principal-agent relationship in tomorrow's lecture at 8:15. Thank you.